What if the world ran on pure energy instead of oil? This is the audacious vision that Elon Musk and Tesla set out to achieve. Some people, Tesla might seem like they're crafting fancy toys for the well-off, but for others, they're basically changing the game by bringing high-tech electric cars to the masses. In this video, we're going to dig into Tesla's backstory, the ups and downs they face, and how they ended up becoming one of the most disruptive, innovative, and buzzed about companies on the planet. Back in 2003, two American engineers, Martin Eberhard and Mark Tarpanin, kicked off something big in San Carlos, California. They founded a company initially named Tesla Motors, a name they later changed to just Tesla in 2017. The inspiration behind the name came from Nikola Tesla, a famous inventor from the 19th century known for his work on rotating electromagnetic fields. Now, why did these two start Tesla? Well, in 2003, General Motors recalled all its EV1 electric cars, and that got Martin and Mark thinking. They saw a golden opportunity in the higher fuel efficiency of battery electric cars, aiming to create a new market that challenged the traditional belief that high-performance cars meant lower fuel economy. In 2004, they went looking for venture capital, and guess who they connected with? None other than Elon Musk. He was totally sold on their vision and put in over $300 million as startup capital. Elon served as chairman of the board and Martin Eberhard became the official CEO. Alongside them, Mark Tarpanin, Ian Wright, and J.D. Straubel were all considered original co-founders of Tesla. Their vision was simple, to make a fully electric sports vehicle and be a tech-focused company, always evolving their battery, motor, and software. Elon Musk took an active role, overseeing a lot of the design and engineering of their first model, the Roadster, between 2006 and 2008. To get things rolling, Elon led multiple capital raising phases from 2006 to 2008, pulling in around $100 million in private funding. This was the key for kickstarting production for the Roadster. The initial prototypes hit the public eye in mid-2006, and by 2008, Tesla officially started making the Roadster. Now, the Roadster was a game changer. It became the first production car to use lithium-ion battery cells. This was no small feat. Tesla had managed something that no other car manufacturer had done before, engineering and producing a fully electric vehicle that could meet the needs of modern consumers. It really went above and beyond what anyone expected, kickstarting Tesla's incredible journey and laying the foundation for the extraordinary adventure. Now, the first Tesla on the block could go a cool 250 miles on just one charge, matching speeds with those flashy sports cars. Sounds impressive, right? But here's the twist. This cool ride, the Roadster, experienced some difficulties along the way as it came with a fancy price tag, over $100,000, making it more of a luxury item than something everyone could get their hands on. And oh, the charging time. The first gen Roadster took around 24 to 48 hours to juice up on a regular household outlet. In the midst of all this, Tesla's leadership was doing a bit of a shuffle. The original CEO, Martin Eberhard, stepped down in 2007, claiming he was pushed out without a word. The interim CEO, Michael Marx, held the fort until Zev Drolery took over in 2007, steering the ship and making sure the Roadster hit the market in 2008. But before the Roadster hit the streets, the original founders, Martin Eberhard and Mark Tarpanin, hit the road themselves, leaving Tesla. Cue the rumors and speculations about what was happening behind the scenes. In the middle of all this drama, Elon Musk, now the big boss, made some bold moves. He trimmed down the workforce, cutting about 30% of Tesla's staff to save costs and get ready for the Roadster's big debut. It ruffled some feathers, but Elon had his eyes on the prize, survival. Now, despite the Roadster rolling out in 2009, Tesla faced a cash crunch. By early 2010, they had less than $10 million, way less than what they needed to deliver the cars they'd already promised. Then came the US Department of Energy with the $465 million lifeline. This cash injection made the way for Tesla's first factory in Fremont, California, and fast-tracked the production of their game changer, the Model S. The Model S marked Tesla's big move into the mass market, introducing an electric family sedan that could seat up to 7 people and cover an impressive 300 miles on a single charge. With a starting price of $74,990, it still carried a hefty tag, but it somehow showed Tesla's commitment to bringing down prices and making electric cars accessible to mainstream consumers. On June 29, 2010, Tesla made headlines by going public on the NASDAQ at $17 per share, raising a big $230 million. This move was historic, as Tesla became the first American car company to go public since Ford's IPO in 1956. The IPO provided much-needed financial stability and improved public perception. In 2012, the Model S went into full-scale production and made an immediate impact, winning Motor Trend's Car of the Year award. By the end of that year, Tesla phased out the Roadster to focus on enhancing its line of sedans. In the same year, Tesla also revealed its first charging station, known as Superchargers. Initially, there were 6 in California, and now there are thousands worldwide. These superchargers offered free and faster charging for Tesla owners compared to standard household outlets. Tesla achieved much bigger milestones in 2013, fully repaying its $465 million loan from the U.S. Department of Energy and posting its first quarterly profit in its decade-long history. Even with all this success, skeptics questioned Tesla's ability to sell enough vehicles for a viable business, especially considering the challenges faced by other automakers in electric EV sales. In December 2012, Tesla announced a European distribution center in the Netherlands, making its first factory outside the U.S. The company expanded its EV lineup in 2012, launching the Model S luxury sedan and announcing plans for its first SUV, the Model X, set to launch in late 2015. In 2014, Tesla revealed plans to open its first Gigafactory in Storey County, Nevada, by 2016. This Gigafactory would supply battery packs for Tesla vehicles. Also, Tesla diversified into home-based solar energy products, introducing the Powerwall for home energy storage and a larger power pack for commercial utility. The Powerwall and Power Pack were immediate hits, receiving orders valued at over $800 million within a week of their unveiling. In 2016, Tesla expanded its sustainable energy portfolio by acquiring solar panel manufacturer SolarCity for $2.6 billion in stock. Despite SolarCity's financial challenges at the time of acquisition, it proved instrumental in accelerating Tesla's overall growth and integrating sustainable energy products into its offerings. In 2017, Tesla continued its bold expansion by introducing a Model 3 sedan to the mass market at a significantly lower price compared to their other models. Priced at around $37,000, the Model 3 played a big role in helping Tesla capture a larger share not only in the electric vehicle market, but also in the broader automobile market. The same year, Tesla inaugurated its second Gigafactory in Buffalo, New York, focusing on the production of solar cells, assembly of modules for solar panels, supercharger equipment, and their innovative solar shingles. Tesla's operations, financials, and public perception were really strong and fast, drawing in investors despite the volatility of its stock price. The company's rapid expansion, market share gains, and swift product launches contributed to its appeal. And then the year 2018 brought both hard things and achievements for Tesla and its CEO, Elon Musk. Elon, who was deeply involved in multiple projects across Tesla, SpaceX, and the Boring Company, faced criticism from investors and the media for his ambitious plans. In August 2018, Musk tweeted about taking Tesla private, causing public backlash and leading to a federal lawsuit by the Securities and Exchange Commission. Elon and Tesla settled the lawsuit, agreeing to pay a $40 million fine. Despite the public scrutiny, Elon's 100-hour work weeks and Tesla's impressive market cap, surpassing the combined value of the 9 largest car companies, showed the company's amazing achievements under his leadership. Tesla wasn't just disrupting the automotive industry. It was fundamentally transforming it and prompting other car manufacturers to adapt. Now, we can say that Tesla's journey started with a spark, but it's evolving into a full-blown inferno of innovation. Their vision isn't confined to sleek cars gliding down city streets. It's about reshaping the entire transportation landscape and beyond. Their future plans are ambitious, and they're already making serious strides. Take the Model Y, for example. The compact SUV is already a sales champion, and Tesla plans to ramp up production to 1 million units annually by 2025. Imagine a world where every other car on the road is a silent, zero-emission powerhouse. Take, for example, the Cybertruck. This futuristic truck with its sharp lines and alien vibe is more than just a head-turner. It's a symbol of Tesla's willingness to push boundaries and redefine what a truck can be. Expect to see them rolling off production lines in 2024, ready to tackle any terrain. Take, for instance, the Semi. Tesla's not forgetting the big boys. Their electric semi-truck promises to revolutionize the trucking industry with its extended range and reduced emissions. Imagine clearer air on highways and a significant dent in carbon footprint. That's the Semi's game plan. Take, for instance, the robo-taxi. Elon Musk had big dreams for self-driving cars, and the Tesla robo-taxi fleet is the first step. This is a world where you hail a self-driving Tesla and arrive at your destination safely and efficiently. This future might be closer than you think. And honestly, let's not forget that the Tesla's ambition extends beyond the four wheels. Their future plans include energy domination. Tesla's solar panels and Powerwall batteries are changing the way we generate and store energy. Imagine homes powered by the sun with Tesla batteries storing the excess for a rainy day. A decentralized, sustainable energy future is within reach. And they want AI to be everywhere. Tesla's autopilot and full self-driving technologies are pushing the boundaries of artificial intelligence. The cars that can learn and adapt, making our roads safer and more efficient. As far as Elon's other venture, SpaceX, even though this might seem unrelated, but the two companies are working together on some exciting projects. They are using Starlink satellites for real-time traffic updates and in-car internet access for Tesla vehicles. Looking ahead, Tesla shows no signs of slowing down its innovation and remains committed to its mission of accelerating the world's transition to sustainable energy and leaving an impact on the whole industry. Honestly, as of today, Tesla's impact on the automotive industry is undeniable. They've forced traditional car makers to rethink their priorities and invest in electric vehicles. Big names like Ford, GM, and Toyota are now scrambling to catch up. This shift is driving down the cost of electric cars and making them more accessible to everyone. Tesla's impact goes beyond cars. They're accelerating the transition to renewable energy, pushing the boundaries of AI, and even inspiring innovation in other sectors like space exploration. Their vision is ambitious, but their progress is undeniable. The future painted by Tesla is one where clean energy powers our lives, AI assists us in every aspect, and transportation is transformed. It's a future that's not just possible, it's already being built, one electric mile at a time. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe to our channel and let us know what you think about Tesla. Is Tesla truly sustainable or just swapping one set of environmental problems for another?